Welcome, friends. Welcome back to the kitchen. Welcome back to Sunday morning in the old cookbook show. Today we're going to be doing something out of this cookbook from 1916, the Ryzon baking book. Price $1. So this is from a collection of cookbooks that I have specifically from companies that make baking powders. And I've got cookbooks from the late 1850s right up until the period just before World War II from a number of different baking powder companies. This is just one of them. And if there's a common thread between all of these cookbooks is how cutthroat the baking powder business must have been at this point in history, and how cutthroat the marketing is, and the language that they use to prove that their product is the purest baking powder available, and that all of the other ones are just complete garbage. They're poison. I mean, get real. Ryzon is the only pure baking powder. All of the rest of them are poison. And this one goes a little bit farther in that it has some fantastic color photographs in it. So they would be hand-painted photographs and then reproduced here in the book. But at the back, there are photographs of the people working in the factory, and they're all in lab coats and how clean it is. There's a shot of the lab, and all of the men are in lab coats. They're looking through microscopes. There's a little blurb about absolute cleanliness is maintained in the building and amongst the workers, who are examined at regular intervals by a physician. And that quote is right above a picture of the women's lavatory. I guess that's to prove that it was a really clean facility. They took the utmost care in order to make baking powder. And I guess I didn't know that there was that much money in baking powder. I really didn't. Some of them boast about how many tons of baking powder they can make in a day. Anyway, this book is a mix of prize-winning recipes that were sent in, and the ones at the front, the real prize winners get a full page with a color photograph in the recipe. We're going to go a little bit farther into the book. I want to make Ryzon Virginia spoonbread, mostly because it uses grits. And grits aren't something that is regularly found in a Canadian kitchen. They just aren't. You can find them at some grocery stores if you look really hard. You can order them online, of course, but they're not something, if when you go into the cereal section, it would just be one brand, and that would be the Quaker Quick Grits. So, we're going to start out. I've separated 6 eggs, yolks and whites. I've got some cornmeal here. Now, it asks specifically for white cornmeal. None of the grocery stores near me sell white cornmeal, so I'm going to use the yellow. To that, I'm adding salt, sugar, and of course, the baking powder. And I'm just going to give that a little bit of a whisk to bring it together. And yes, I was supposed to put the sugar and the salt in with the egg yolks when I started whipping them. It's going to be okay. It'll be just fine. So, a little bit of a whip on the egg yolks, and to that I'm going to add the already cooked grits. And we'll whip those in. Looking good. So now we need 3 cups of sweet milk, which is just regular milk. Regular milk is sweet milk in this time period. Do I get 3 cups? Oh, 3 cups. And they call it sweet milk just to differentiate between that and sour milk and or buttermilk. So it asks for a cup of buttermilk, and I'll put that in now. There we go. So 4 cups of liquid total. Next it says to pretty much add everything in all at once. I'm going to add in a little bit of the milk first. And then a little bit of the cornmeal. I find that it can clump together really quickly if you don't sort of go back and forth. That's my experience from other recipes anyway. Okay, so all the cornmeal is in. And now I'll put in the rest of the milk. There we go. Now, it says to whip the egg whites to a froth, but it also tells me to melt the butter in the bottom of the baking dish. So I'm going to put that in the oven to melt it. And we'll whip up these egg whites. And yes, this recipe is earlier than the invention of the electric hand mixer. It's not too difficult to do this by hand, just with a whisk. Really simple. You don't need a hand mixer. Just makes your life really easy. Speeds things up a lot. So now I need to fold these in. And the first lump or the first third mix in, you don't really have to worry too much about folding. And because the batter at this point that's already in the container is so liquidy, you need some of that egg white just to stiffen it up a little bit. Everything is now folded in, and I've realized that the original dish that I thought I would cook this in just wasn't going to cut it. So I've switched to a larger dish, and I'll get that out. The butter has heated in the bottom, and we'll just pour this mixture in. I don't know how this is going to work out, because to me, the uncooked yellow cornmeal is just going to sink to the bottom and create a layer on the bottom. Maybe that's what it's supposed to be. Who knows? The top is going to be light and airy. It's going to be like a souffle. So this goes into the oven. And it just says to bake in a moderate oven. So I've got it set to 350 and we'll see what happens.
Hi, Glen.
Hey, Jules.
Hey, friends.
So I am cautiously optimistic about this. I think there's...
It's a beautiful color.
It is a beautiful color. And it...
Why are you concerned?
It puffed up really nicely, although it deflated after it came out of the oven. It's a souffle-ish kind of thing.
Yeah, I can smell the egginess to it.
Yeah. Yeah, so one of the things I was worried about was, and you can see it a little bit, that the mixture was so light, there was so much liquid, that the cornmeal would just drop to the bottom, and the cornmeal wasn't cooked ahead of time. And that's what's happened. So
yeah,
you've got a cornmeal layer.
Is it supposed to be a crust on the bottom?
I don't know. It might be. I mean, I've never had Virginia spoon bread. So maybe it's supposed to be. There's not a lot of flavoring in it, just a little bit of salt and a tiny bit of sugar.
It's somewhat bland, but not unappealing. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Like it's egg and
cornmeal.
It's egg. Yeah.
It's a really moist cornbready kind of thing.
Yeah.
I would put in stuff like jalapenos, pickled jalapenos. Take it in a completely different direction.
I would have put strawberry jam on it, but you know.
Julie would have put strawberry jam on it. So there you go. It could be taken.
Jam and eggs. I happen to like jam and eggs, so.
You could go savory, you could go sweet.
Yeah, so it's not unpleasant. It's just bland.
Yeah, it is bland.
It's not an awful texture. I was waiting for the cornmeal to have some kind of a...
Gloopy.
Yeah, kind of. Thank you for the... Gloopy is better than my sound effect.
Bacon.
It needs bacon.
Now, if you thought of it as a breakfast dish, right?
Yeah.
And you threw in some bacon and all sorts of other breakfasty kind of...
Oh, and so you could put in bacon and like diced up green pepper.
Yeah.
And diced up onion, and it would almost be like a breakfast buffet souffle kind of thing.
It's like a souffle. It's almost like a quiche.
That's the direction.
It's like a crustless quiche.
That's the direction I take that in. That is a really good idea. Okay, so there's so many great ideas. And I would suggest that, you know, if you want to buy a really good baking powder, try Ryzon. Although I don't know that they're still in business. They might be.
If you find it, let us know.
Let us know. But I have to tell you, the women's service lavatory is spotless.
Ooh, it does shine.
It does shine. Thanks for stopping by. See you again soon.